Hello, fourth class students. My name is Jagpreet Kaur, and today we will do a new topic, that is tense, from your English language, chapter number 19. If I say, what is tense? Tense is time. So, time tells us whether the action has taken place in present, past, or future. Here is example for more clarification. Tense is time. So there are three types of time or tense we can say. First is present, second is past, and another one is future. Present is today. Are you getting my point? Present is today. Past is yesterday. And future is tomorrow. That will come. That is future. Tomorrow will come. So tomorrow is our future. Here is the example. She sings a song. She sings a song. Here, sings is the verb. It tells us action is taking place in the present. Action is taking place in the present. Another example of past. He swam in the river. Here, swam is the verb. Through swam, we come to know that action took place in the past. He will go to school. Here, will go tells us that action will take place in the future. So, is it clear? One more thing. Actually, verb is having different use in different tenses. Here is the chart for more clarification. Now, first of all, we will do present, simple present tense. Here, singular or first person, second person or third person. I have written over here, tense, first person, second person and third. In simple present tense, I write over here, I write a letter, okay? In second person, I will write you. As you know that second person is you, first person is I and we. And the third person is he, she, they or it. So, we write a letter in second person, you write a letter in third person, they write a letter. This is simple present tense. Next comes present continuous tense. Here, I am writing a letter. Here, I write ing with verb first form. Here, I have written, I am writing a letter. In present continuous tense, we write the verb first form plus ing. So, here, you are writing a letter. Then, third person, he or she is writing a letter. Then comes present perfect tense. In singular, I have written a letter. In present perfect tense, I will use have or has. I will use have with I. With you, I will use have. Then with he or she, I will use has. And third form of the verb. I will use third form of the verb in present perfect tense. Now comes next, that is simple past tense. In singular, I wrote a letter. Here, I am writing over here, wrote. Verb second form. In present tense, I had written write. Verb first form. And in past, I will use verb second form. So here, I have written wrote a letter. Like in second, you wrote a letter. In third person, she wrote a letter. So, in simple past tense, we will use second form of the verb. Then, past continuous. I was writing a letter. I will use was or were plus verb, first form of the verb plus ing. Then I was writing a letter. In our present continuous tense, I had written over here, I am. Here I will write, I was writing a letter. Now the difference is clear to everyone, that in the present continuous tense, I was writing over here, I am, and in past continuous tense, I have written over here, I was writing a letter. Now next. Now, in past perfect tense, I will write over here, I had written a letter. I had written a letter. I will use had in the past perfect tense in everywhere. In first person, I had. In second person also, you had. In third person also, she or he had written a letter. Then comes simple future tense. I shall write a letter. In future tense, we use shall with I, or we shall, or we will. Okay, in simple future tense we use will or first form of the verb. Again, in future continuous tense, I will write over here, I shall be writing a letter. I will write shall plus be plus verb first form or ing. Then future perfect tense. In future perfect tense, I will write over here, I shall have written a letter. I shall have written a letter. You will have written a letter. Then again, she will have written a letter. So, I hope that all the things are clear to you. In past perfect tense, we will write had with first person, second or third person also. In future perfect tense, we will use I shall, you shall, we shall, and you will have written. Okay. Now there is a homework for fourth class students. Try to solve the exercises on the book with pencil. Thank you.